Good morning. It's Wednesday, April 29th, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, Worship from a Distance. And our scripture is Exodus chapter 24. Then the Lord instructed Moses, "Come up here to me and bring along Aaron, Nadab, Abihu, and 70 of Israel's elders. All of you must worship from a distance. Only Moses is allowed to come near to the Lord. The others must not come near, and none of the other people are allowed to climb up the mountain with him." A few days ago, I had to get an x-ray done. When I entered the facility, everyone was wearing masks. When I walked into the room with the big machine, the small talk moment was a hello nod. The first words from the masked man were, "You're wearing gloves?" I answered in the affirmative because it's hard to ignore robin's egg blue latex on all 10 fingers. Then I got a lecture on the medical mistakes I was making, such as cross-contaminating everything my gloves touch and how, underneath the offending gloves, the unventilated sweating of my hands was providing a perfect storm of bacteria. It was a monologue that lasted the full 10 minutes it took to look at my insides with that magic machine. I found myself bristling at this sermonic tsunami of medical expertise coming from a mouth I couldn't see, probably quite unventilated under there, and, I surmised, only loosely fact-checked. My last bristling thought was, I wonder if he knows how much of a bacteria-perfect storm is brewing in that cave underneath his face mask. The x-ray tech must have sensed my bristling. I'm not a good poker-faced sort when held captive under 3 tons of equipment, forced to listen to how I'm ruining the universe and mom's apple pie with my blue gloves. Well, he took a little breath break in the middle of his diatribe to inform me that he was just trying to educate me. I have to admit, my first words to this man I'd never met surprised even my natural affinity for sarcasm. I replied, "I guess all those surgeons are wrong about wearing gloves." When I left the room, there was no goodbye nod. I suppose most people are registering higher on the Richter scale of edgy these days. Even though I'm trying my best to stay calm underneath my mask, taking deep breaths, not adding to the national debt of angst, it is getting harder. And, like Aaron and the 70 elders, I'm not happy with having to stay at a safe distance, especially in worship. I grew up with a prevailing sentence ringing in my ears every Sunday morning as our pastor's morning prayer always included the phrases that thanked God for this land where we're still free to gather and worship. I'm a lot older now and hopefully a little wiser. This land is still a God-given beautiful place. The free part, not as much. I never thought I'd live to see the day when we had to close the church doors at the direction of political fiat. Closing the church doors was always a euphemism for the consequences of God's people behaving like the world, a fate to be suffered by congregations too afraid or lazy to do the kingdom work of spreading the good news. But here we are. We have been social distanced out of the sanctuary. Only the proverbial resident church mice abide under the steeples of the houses of worship. Now our altar is an iPad or a desktop screen or, for more contemporary types, a smartphone. There's no embrace across the pews, handshaking, offering plate passing, lingering, or holy hush moments. The hymnals lie collecting dust along with a Sunday school roll book. We have kept our distance. Now, if that's the lament, here's the joyous response of praise. We have been forced from the forms of worship to which we'd become stagnated and unprofitably glued and launched back into the first century catacombs, finding dangerous ways to follow the Christ who still indwells, still calls, and still gifts to do his bidding, no matter the cost. For you today, there are times for distancing. distancing from sin, from forms of godliness which deny the power of God, and so on. But there is nothing that can ever social distance God's people from His love. Let's dwell on Paul's words on that promise. Romans 8:38, "And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow, not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love." You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.